and welcome. You're watching Vision Plus. Without a vision, the people perish. And what you see in the background is Bernice Turner. And you're going to learn a lot. It's about a book and a documentary that's coming out about this amazing lady that you have seen in many magazines and newspapers and shows around the world. And we're actually in her home on location in Memphis, Tennessee now, and I want you to hear her story. She played her first concert at age 5, and she will correct me in anything that I have said incorrectly, and we call it from dirt, scrabble, poor to the wealth of the nations. Here and welcome to Bernice Turner.
Thank you, Bonnie. It's so good to be here. And I want to thank you for coming. We have been friends for 50 years, 70 years. I guess about 70 years ago. No, 60 years ago I met you. And this is a pleasure, and thank you for coming. And I started playing music. Well, my whole family played music. I have a picture of my daddy, Floyd Hilburn. I was born in Black Rock, Arkansas, and my dad was Floyd Hilburn. My mother was Clem Crooms Higgins, Hilburn Higgins. And then my uncle Homer Hilburn and Owen Hilburn played in the 20s in a orchestra band in Lynn, Arkansas. And so my mother, my grandmother, my grandfather, everybody played music. And we lived on top of a big hill in Black Rock. And my uncle was Sheriff Dexter Harris there in Black Rock, and my granddad had a furniture store, and my uncle, Jesse Probst, my aunt's husband, had a drugstore there, and my granddaddy got us all kinds of music, and the boys lived around in houses around the hill, and so we'd all get up on Sunday morning, and grandmother would put on a pot of beans and pinto beans normally with a little bit of meat, and we would go to the Church of Christ, all of us, and then when we got, we'd all go back to grandmother's house instead of our own houses, and whoever got there first would pick up whatever instrument they wanted to play. So we'd all try to get there first where we could play. I hated mandolin because those two strings would cut your fingers in two. So I tried to play mostly the guitar, but I played piano and drums and everything, because that's the way we did back then. And so then Lonnie Glosson and Wayne Rainey, some people may remember him. Lonnie Glosson is playing the harmonica, I Want My Mama. They were at XEG Del Rio, Texas. And I know coming in from our shows back in the 40s and 50s, we would listen to them on XEG Del Rio, Texas. They would come over that station. But when I was 5 years old, my cousin, Gene Hilburn, who now lives in Walnut Ridge, Arkansas, is 3 days older than I am. I was born on January the 13th, 1927. And Gene is 3 days older than I am. And so she played the mandolin and I played the guitar. And at the end of school, I was so little, I couldn't get on the stage with the guitar, but I got on the stage. My daddy helped me on the stage, and I got up in the chair. Then daddy put the guitar in my lap, and Gene played the mandolin, and we sang two songs, When It's Springtime in the Rockies and Mexicali Rose. That was our first stage show. And then when I was about 9 and 10, well, then we opened several shows at schoolhouses around over in Arkansas. for Lonnie, especially Lonnie Glosson and Wayne Rainey. And then Lonnie, I think he was about 100 when he died a couple of years ago.
And I have to tell you, I knew there was something special about you. Wayne Rainey is my daughter's uncle.
You're kidding.
Yeah, no, I'm not. I saw in the Grand Ole the Opryland Hotel that he had won an award. Uh-huh. And we got to get to some of the awards and people that you've played with in addition to them. I just couldn't resist that.
Yeah, he had a big studio, Wayne did, up in Arkansas later on in years, you know. But anyway, Lonnie played every year. He played the country show downtown here in Memphis, and he would come out and spend the day here, and I would tape our conversations, and I've got pictures of him all over the place of during the latter part of his life, which I think he died about 7 or 8 years ago. And but this is a magazine here I wanted to give you on yesterday's memories, that they did a big article on me, and there's pictures of me and Sam Phillips in here. In fact, when Sam died, Steve Mays, the owner of the magazine that publishes the magazine, called me, and he said, "Now I called Sam to get a quote from you." From him when I did an article on you, so I'm calling you now to get an article on Sam. This is when he died, and so I did an interview on Sam. He was just so special to me. He was just, Sam has been a many a night at my home, and with my son and Robbie Turner. And then, and his children is very special to me, and Sally, his secretary that he was friends with all of those years, and that lived with him. And this is me and Knox Phillips, Sam's son. This was at a opening for Johnny Cash show down at the, they were honoring Johnny downtown on Beale Street. And this is a picture of me and Knox Phillips. And then some other pictures that I'm giving you that I used to have in my courtyard outside. I used to have a lot of political parties for the sheriff and for the governor and different people. And so, here is Joe Brown. Here's the Barquets were playing. Here is Joe Brown that's on TV dancing under my carport, and the Barquets were playing. So anyway,
just go right through those pictures for me.
And this, okay, and then here's me and Ed Bradley on 60 Minutes.
Hold it up a little longer.
And okay, it's me and Ed Bradley on 60 Minutes. And here's Tommy Cash, Johnny Cash's brother. This is, I lost a brother and a sister and a daughter last year. And this is Jill Turner, my daughter that I lost last year. From cancer, and which was the worst time I've ever gone through in my 79 years of life.
How long did she have cancer?
She had cancer about 3 years before she finally died, and I stayed with her night and day.
What kind of cancer was it?
Of the lymph nodes. She had cancer of the
lymph
nodes.
Not of the breast.
Yeah, right. Uh-huh.
Not breast cancer.
And and then here's a picture of me and Sam Phillips that I was given Bonnie. And then I have a bunch of pictures made years ago at the Grand Ole Opry. I have one of Patsy Cline made on the Grand Ole Opry, and